Hey you guys, I'm back with another story time. I wanted to talk about three strange situations that happened to me. You know, first situation was, I was at my second job, right? And a customer was trying to purchase a stroller, and you know how customers they sometimes put items over the wrong price so they can get it for less. So I was rushing to the baby section so I can do a price check to make sure that the stroller was in the correct area, okay? So this lady out of nowhere was like, excuse me, miss, can you help me? I'm like, do you not see that I'm rushing trying to, you know, check something for a customer? And it was another employee standing right there, and she kept saying, ma'am, she's busy right now. You know, if you need any help, I can help you. And she was like, I don't want your help. I asked her to help me, right? So I was like, I'm sorry, miss, but I'm trying to hurry up and check a price on a stroller. I don't have time to help you. I'm busy with somebody else. And so the other employee was like, I'll help you with whatever it is that you need help with. So I was like, oh my God, that is so awkward. Like, why would she single me out of the other employee reaching out trying to get my attention, okay? So that was kind of strange to me. I'm like, okay, this lady, you know, behaving like she's obsessed. I mean, not obsessed, but like, excuse me, she possessed, okay? That's the word that I'm trying to use. And so I just brushed it off like awkward. And then you went and, you know, checked the price on the stroller. And there was another incident that happened where I was in the elevator, and it was other people getting on the elevator, okay? And this lady, she stood next to me on my right side, and then, like, she turned her head towards me, okay, staring at the side of my face, like, for a good minute, all right? And I'm like, why is she staring at the side of my face like that and not saying, and she, because, you know, I could see through the side of my eyes, and I noticed that she was, you know, making weird facial expressions while she was staring at the side of my face. And I felt like a little kind of uncomfortable. And I was like, oh my God, please don't let this lady try to attack me. And there was other people in the elevator. I'm like, why she just chose me to stare at? Like, that is kind of weird. Like, it's people on her right side that she could stare at. And she just decided to turn towards me and was staring at me for a good minute, okay? And then when the elevator doors opened up, that's when she turned her head away from me and got off the elevator. And I was like, oh, that is freaking strange. Like, why was she, you know, staring at me like that and didn't say anything? Okay, so that was a strange situation right there. Another incident was when I was going to, you know, deposit a check in my account, right? And from the ATM. And it was like where I was going to deposit it at, it was like a lot of people in that area, you know, I don't know if they were going to work or they were, you know, shopping or whatever, but it was like a lot of people walking back and forth, right? So after I deposited the check and proceeded to, you know, walk away from the ATM, right? This lady was coming towards me that was talking to herself. She was like having a whole conversation with herself out loud. And all these other people was walking past her. And then when she got to me, she turned to me and was like, make sure you get home safe. And she was like, hurry up and get home safe. And then after she said that, she continued like walking away from me, talking to herself. And I was like, why would she, you know, single me out of everybody else that's walking past her? She wait until she gets to me and stop communicating with herself and to tell me that, to, you know, make sure I get home safe and to hurry up, like. And that was like strange to me. And I was like, oh my gosh, like, you know, could it be like a message, like, you know, somebody reaching out to me, or, you know, a possessed entity, you know, like, that's trying to communicate with me, you know, because like I draw like negative, like, you know, people that have like a negative spirit, like trying to like communicate, but the way they do it is like kind of weird, you know, like it's like awkward, you know, like it makes me, you know, feel kind of uncomfortable. But I kind of like brush it off because I'm protected, so, you know, like I have people watching over me. So that was like three, you know, like weird, strange incidents that happened. Okay. I'm gonna try to do some more, you know, because I have to, you know, go and think about all the stuff that, you know, I had experienced, because, you know, I don't, you know, so I won't be looking silly when I'm telling these stories. But that was kind of awkward. I was like, why be a negative spirit, like trying to like reach out, you know, for my attention? Or sometimes it don't be like a negative person that try to reach out to me, like, you know, to deliver a message. But it's just strange how, you know, I come across these things.